Miss Eden Capwell?
Yes.
These are for you.
Mr. Castillo.
What?
Are you Mr. Castillo?
Yeah.
Could you sign right here, please? Looks like you recognize these from someplace.
Yes, the last time I got these, it was a special occasion. Actually, it was more than that. It was...
only the most important night of my life. I don't think that's such a good idea.
Well, there was a certain delivery made a few minutes ago. Doesn't it change something?
Well, I don't see how. It doesn't erase what happened.
Well, I know, but Cruisers just can't walk away from this gesture.
What do you want me to do? Orient Express. You know, sometimes I forget how that place got its name.
From us.
From where we started.
Well, at least you haven't forgotten that.
And you know I never will, Eden. That doesn't mean we can go back.
I'll see you in an hour. Maybe we can go back, Cruz.
I don't want to hear it.
Hey, look at it. I know I said that before, right? But, I mean, doesn't a guy have a right to change his mind in this country?
Besides, a little time off wouldn't hurt you. I mean, it might be just what the doctor ordered for you.
Well, I had to do something. I mean, that much was obvious.
Yeah, those are pretty flowers, you know. Mind if I have a smell? They smell great. You get them for somebody?
Eden sent it to me.
Yeah. Well, doesn't that usually mean something when a lady sends a guy flowers?
Girl, I don't want to talk about it,
boy,
okay?
Oh, boy. I mean, you are so damn touchy whenever I bring up her name. Everybody knows you're acting like a Neanderthal because of her. Everybody knows you took a leave of absence
Look,
for that reason.
I wish people would stop reminding me of what's wrong with my life. You think I don't know how screwed up it is? I do, believe me. She could send me flowers every day from now to the end of the year. It doesn't make the clock go backwards, Pearl. It doesn't change what's happened.
They're pretty, anyway.
First time I saw him was when Eden and I were on the Orient Express traveling through Europe. I'll never forget how she looked. We didn't say much to each other, you know? It was like, at a certain point in time, the train came to a halt and, some mechanical thing, I don't know. We looked out and, there was a meadow filled with those flowers. I got off and picked as many as I could carry. I left them in a compartment. That was the first night Eden and I were close. It felt like the first night of my life. And I knew.
Yeah. You knew? You knew what?
I'm Nothing, obviously.
Well, you get off my desk, man. Why are you always on my desk?
All right, I'm off. You want to hear what my philosophy on this whole thing is? You got to stop thinking so hard about this whole thing. You were just telling me this beautiful story about this lovely woman that you cast your eyes upon and you fell in love. It's just some of the great American story. You didn't at that time look at the situation, try to analyze it, you know, what might go wrong, how things could develop into problems, you know, does she gargle in the morning, what is her world political opinion about? You didn't fight your feelings then, so don't fight your feelings now. You know what they stand for? The past. That's good with you, because the past is still alive in you. I don't know how to say this. You and Eden, you still have a chance to boogie. She's willing to give it her best shot, but you can't let your machismo stand in the way.
Machismo has nothing to do with this.
Cruz, you're my friend. I don't want to stand by and see you get more and more bitter. You can't ignore this problem anymore. You can't ignore Eden. Can't afford to. It might be your last chance.
Hi. Hi, actually, Lionel, we're going to be closing the restaurant in about 45 minutes for a private party.
Well, I just came to see Julia. I won't stay long.
Oh, she's right over there.
Julia? Why are you closing the restaurant down?
Well, these came this morning. Cruz sent them.
Remember?
Well, he gave them to me on the Orient Express when we were in Europe. I mean, I'd almost thought he'd forgotten. I'd almost lost hope.
You're sure you're not reading too much into this?
Oh, no, Mason. He would never do this unless he was serious. I mean, I'd almost forgotten. And then I saw these and it brought everything back. Don't you see, Mason? These were the beginning for us, and Cruz wants a new beginning. So do I.
I thought you were going to stop doing this kind of thing.
What?
I thought I made myself pretty clear. You said you weren't going to pursue it.
I thought...
I've been trying to figure out what the hell I'm going to do now. I mean, I've got all these pieces. I'm trying to line them up in some kind of... You think I need to be reminded of how much I've lost?
I thought this is what you wanted.
No.
The flowers seemed like a gesture.
Uh-huh. A very painful one.
Was that why you did it? Because you wanted to hurt me?
What do you mean, hurt you?
I thought you had a change of heart. I mean, you know what these mean to me. I thought that...
Wait. I didn't send these to you. But I got the ones that you sent me.
In the card?
I got one exactly like you got one. You got this too?
Yes, I did.
What is this, some kind of a joke?
Obviously, it's just somebody's misguided attempt to get us together.
Who would do something like that?
Please, you've got to know that I wouldn't do anything like this. Our time in Europe was too important to me. I would never use a memory like this.
I know, of course not. I'm sorry.
Oh, yes, so am I.
Forgive me, when I came in here, I just assumed that, this is all a mistake.
Maybe it wasn't a mistake. doesn't matter who sent them.
No, I guess it doesn't.
It made you think of that time, didn't it? The first time that we were together.
You know, it did. I've never been able to look at these particular flowers without thinking about that time.
The train was moving through the mountains, and there were these flowers everywhere. It was so beautiful. You walked in through the door. You didn't even ask me if I could invite you in.
You were so beautiful. I didn't know if I could make it through another hour if I couldn't touch you.
Oh, that night was perfect, wasn't it? And we've been trying so hard to get it back to that. We almost did at the chateau.
Yeah, yeah. Except that we weren't really. Look, I just think that we need to move on, and stuff like this makes it more difficult.
You know, when I was getting ready for this, and I was arranging the flowers, and I was putting on the music, I forgot everything that's happened these past few months. And I thought that that was what was happening with you. You were at home, thinking up some wonderful surprise like you always do. I guess I let my mind get away with me.
Yeah, you did.
But didn't you too?
It's impossible to ignore what has happened. It's impossible for me, anyway.
Maybe for 5 minutes. I mean, we're here together. We could have 5 minutes where we could just escape. No one would know. We could dance. Just one dance.
Delivered from your home, Miss Capwell.
Thank you.
How was the private party?
Actually, they never showed up. Oh. Dear Eden, I heard from Mama that you and Cruz have broken up. I know how much the two of you love each other, so I sent the flowers to try and help. I remember you telling me that there was coxcomb all around the train the first night you spent with Cruz. I hope you both were able to take a sentimental journey back. Belong together. I miss you, and I hope I can see you soon. Love, Kelly.
Just the way I imagined you would be.
Can someone tell me why?